Welcome to Unit 5.2. In this unit, we will explore the crystal structure of ethylene. In addition, thereby getting to know the non-standard space group P21 over N, which is another setting of the space group P21 over C. Ethylene, with the chemical formula C2H4, belongs to the so-called unsaturated hydrocarbon compounds due to this double bond between the two carbon atoms. Geometrically, ethylene is a planar molecule. All atoms lie in the same plane, and the bond angles are all 120 degrees. We will take a look at its structure more closely in a second. At room temperature, it is a gas. However, if you cool it down to approximately minus 170 degrees Celsius, which is actually pretty cold, then even ethylene crystallizes, namely in the space group P21 over N, with these specified lattice parameters. Let's shortly recap what P1, 21 over N, 1 means. P, primitive lattice. Then, the symmetry elements are specified according to three viewing directions. The first is A, and there is no symmetry element. In the second viewing direction, there is a 2-1 screw axis parallel to the B direction, and a glide plane N perpendicular to the B direction, and finally, there's no symmetry element in the third direction. In the following, we will explore its crystal structure in 3D, but this time we will do this not with Vesta, but with Mercury, another software allowing to visualize TIFF files. You can find both a download reference for the software as well as the TIFF file of ethylene right next to the video. If you have downloaded the software and opened the TIFF, we will be able to continue together. Okay, let's begin. If you start Mercury with a double click on the TIFF file, you should see something like this. By default, Mercury displays not the whole crystal structure, but in most cases only one formula unit of the compound. Here, our ethylene molecule. We can change the display styles in many ways, and there are some shortcuts for display settings that are incorporated already in Mercury. For instance, we can change the display to the style publication. And we can zoom in a bit by dragging while pressing the right mouse button. While rotating the molecule, we see its flat geometry. Now let's see what the unit cell looks like. For that, you have to click here at the bottom left, Packing. Okay, there are ethylene molecules at every corner of the unit cell. And there is one additional molecule inside the cell, in the center. However, this molecule has a different orientation, therefore it is indeed only a primitive cell. One feature of this software which makes it rather unique is that Mercury is able to display not only the crystal structure, but also the symmetry elements at the same time. And this is really helpful to deeper understand the crystal structure. So let's have a look. Go to the menu Display and then click Symmetry Elements. In this dialog, you can decide which categories of symmetry elements you want to make visible. You can choose different colors and transparencies and so on. By default, all are selected, but I prefer to explore one category of symmetry elements after the other. So let's begin with the center of inversions. Okay, now we see that inversion centers are present at all corners, at all midpoints along the edges, at all centers of the faces, and there is, of course, also a center of inversion in the center of the cell, which is also in the center of our ethylene molecule, and this is interesting. It is also valid for the other molecules at the edges of the cell. Always, the center of inversion is right in the middle of every ethylene molecule. And this means that the one half of our molecule is inverted at this center of inversion to generate the other half of our molecule. And this means that this center of inversion is not only a center of inversion of the crystal structure, but simultaneously a center of inversion of the molecule. These two centers of inversion fall together. Now, what does this mean with respect to our asymmetric unit? Exactly, the asymmetric unit comprises only a half of this ethylene molecule, because the other half is generated by this inversion center. And as mercury also allows us to show only the asymmetric unit, instead of one whole formula unit or the whole unit cell, we can see if we are right. For that, we first have to uncheck the packing option here at the bottom left. And then we can check this box, the asymmetric unit. And yeah, we see indeed it's only the half of our molecule. Okay, let's explore the other remaining symmetry elements. Let's choose the 2-1 screw axes. And I prefer a blue color for them. Alright, here they are. So we have 4 2-1 screw axes which are running parallel to the B direction. So which ethylene molecules are symmetry related to each other by these 2-1 screw axes? Let's see, we could for instance choose this molecule. Let's mark it. And now we can apply this axis. This means we first have to rotate by 180 degrees and then we have to translate the molecule by one half along the B direction. And this means it will be mapped onto this molecule in the center. Now we can apply another 2-1 screw axis to this molecule. And this means that this molecule in the center is now transformed into that one at the corner of the cell. And so on. Okay, let's have a look at the glide planes. Display, symmetry elements. And here you can adjust the transparency, maybe 25% is okay. And now we see actually two glide planes. One at a height along B at 1/4 and another one at 3/4. Maybe some of you are surprised that there are two glide planes. In the respective diagram of the symmetry elements in the international tables, only one was depicted at a height 1/4. This is true, but remember that the present symmetry elements act also on other symmetry elements. So if we have a center of inversion and a glide plane which does not lie at a height 0.5 along B, then this glide plane is also inverted and thereby multiplied, so to say. If we had only one glide plane at 1/4, then this crystal structure could no longer be centrosymmetric. How does this glide plane affect our ethylene molecule? It is a glide plane N, a diagonal glide plane. So let's choose this ethylene molecule in the center. First we have to reflect this molecule, then it lies in the same plane as these molecule at these corners, and then we have to translate the molecule both along the A and the C direction, in total a diagonal movement. Well, because there's still a certain amount of imagination power needed in order to actually see how these molecules are symmetry related to each other by these symmetry elements, Michael produced a nice 3D animation. So let's have a look. First, the 2-1 screw axis is applied to this bottom right ethylene molecule. This means first a rotation around this axis by 180 degrees and second, translation along the B direction by one half. This can also be displayed as a combined movement and now it looks indeed really as a screw rotation. Our ethylene in the role of an artistic gymnast. Now we see the action of a glide plane. The glide plane lies parallel to the AC plane at this height. First, the molecule is reflected at this plane. then it lies at the top plane, and now a translation by 1/2 has to be carried out along the A and then along the C direction. And this is of course a diagonal movement in total, as shown here. Glide plane N, diagonal. Okay, only one point is left for this unit. The space group of ethylene is P21 over N. But P21 over N is not listed as one of the 230 space groups. Does it mean that P21 over N does not exist? Well, of course not. It is only a variant of P21 over C, as well as the two space groups P21 over A or P21 over B. They all differ only in the choice of the direction of the crystallographic axis. Let's see how we can transform the so-called non-standard space groups into the standard one. Let's begin with the standard look of P21 over C, with one angle beta which can be different from 90 degrees. This is the angle between the axes A and C. And I also included in this scheme the impact of the glide plane C. This locomotive is first reflected at this plane and then translated by 1/2 along the C direction. Now let's have a look at the space group P21 over A. The viewing direction in which this glide plane A occurs is still the B direction. As always in the monoclinic crystal system, we look along this B direction. But now glide plane A means that this locomotive is first reflected at this mirror plane and then translated by 1/2 along this direction, along A. It's a glide plane A. So when this is only a variant of the space group P21 over C, another version, so to say, then we should be able to transform this space group P21 over A into P21 over C. How can we achieve this? Well, in this case, we only have to redefine the axis A and C. The old axis A becomes the new C direction, and the old axis C, the new axis A. Marked here with these primes. That's it. The angle beta is still the same. So, space group P21 over N. This means first mirroring at this plane and then a diagonal glide along this direction. So how can we convert this cell into the standard space group P21 over C? We have to redefine the orientations of the axis in such a way that this diagonal will become the new C direction. So our new cell looks like this. Please note that this also changes the angle beta. In contrast to the case before, where only the two axes A and C were interchanged. And here, the angle beta differ more strongly from 90 degrees than before. We have a very skew, a very oblique cell. This is sometimes the reason why researchers choose the P21 over N setting instead of the conventional setting P21 over C, namely when this angle is more closely to 90 degrees. What was here only graphically has, of course, to be done mathematically when dealing with real crystal structures. The cell parameters, length and axis, have to be transformed by a so-called transformation matrix. And also the coordinates of the atoms have to be transformed. But these are only minor and not very interesting mathematical details, and these algebraic operations are not covered by our introductory course. However, for those of you who are interested, a poster on that topic from researchers of Oxford can be found in the reference section, in which this issue is explained a little more.